you know, Max came up with some big goals there, and, you know, we just wanted to play the same way, but it's not easy watching, especially this time.
What do you want to say to the people back in Pittsburgh?
Thank you so much. I mean, you know, we had a tough start this season. They stuck behind us. They've been so loyal to us for a long time, and, you know, they deserve this, so we're really happy to bring it back there.
Congratulations. You're part of an amazing Pittsburgh Penguin legacy. You deserve this.
Thank you very much.
Bach and Edzo.
Just noticed Marc-Andre Fleury overcoming a couple of embarrassing goals in the early part of this series, but it is how you finish, and he finished strong.
Doc, the true colors of someone or some team are not when things are great, but when things are tough. And I think Marc-Andre Fleury certainly showed what he was made of under the adversity of getting pulled in game five, bouncing back, making some great stops in game six, that late save. You talk about Stanley Cup winning saves, Doc. That happened 60 minutes ago in the world of the National Hockey League. The stop on Dan Cleary to keep it a 2-1 Penguin lead. But to me, Marc-Andre Fleury is an elite goaltender and made an unbelievable stop at the end of the game to give the Penguins the Stanley Cup championship.
Can't imagine how he can put his thoughts into words, but he's with Pierre.
Marc-Andre Fleury, your folks, coach of the professional, was Eddie Olczyk. He just said your save at the end of the third period was spectacular. Take us through that save.
I knew there wasn't much time left. The rebound was wide, and I saw it still coming into it. So I know I just had to get my body out there and hit me in the red zone.
They started to have a big push at the tail end of the second period, then through most of the third. How did you stabilize things? What was the mode of communication in your own zone?
You know, they're a good team, you know, we got to give that to them, and they worked hard till the end, and they give us a hard time, you know, to get out of our zone, but the guys, they come close, they stick to their game plan, and they work out well.
You've had a tough time winning in this building. The last time you won in this building in the playoffs was game five last year in triple overtime. What was your thought process coming in to game seven?
You know, forget about the first three ones, and just start over again in this one, and you know, it's pretty awesome.
The cup weighs 35 pounds. I know you're tired from facing a lot of shots. How heavy is it?
I don't know. It wasn't too bad, you know. It's not a bad deal, you know, to get that out, so it's fine.
Thanks a lot, Marc-Andre.
That's cool.
Doc, Edzo.
Saves 22 and 23 were spectacular. Matt Cook and his grandson. Well, you saw Marc-Andre Fleury in control, and you've heard Darren Pang and Mike Milbury talk about it all playoff long and in the Stanley Cup final. Watch the positioning, watch his left leg, watch how he pushes, shuffles over, and then in desperation mode, a couple quick little pushes, Nick Lidstrom looking to elevate that puck, knowing how much time was on the clock, that he had to hurry up, but it was almost just leaning and lunging, making himself look big, but Marc-Andre Fleury in control, and that is an unbelievable stop as time is coming down in game seven of the Stanley Cup final. Equipment man Dana Hines handing it over. A guy in Johnstown who was the backup goaltender and equipment man and actually played and made a save in the game there. Mario Lemieux on the ice and Pierre.
And Mario, it never gets old. You beat it in 91 and 92. You guys had to make some tough organizational decisions. When did you know this group had it in them?
Well, we knew all along from last year going out down to you know, the Stanley Cup Finals, but anytime you have to sit on your team and walk that far, they get a chance to be successful. We had a tough year this year, but made some changes, started to play better towards the end of the year. We had a great run, so. Again, when you have sit on your team, anything's possible.
You told me after game five you guys got beat pretty handily here, that you would be back and you would be fine. What was your message? Because I understand you gave a message to the team before game six. How did you stabilize the situation?
Just that we stick together. We win as a team, we lose as a team. And I just told the guys that we're going back to Pittsburgh. We're going to win game six and win the cup here on Friday, which we did. So it's a great night for all of our fans back home and the organization, the players. I'm proud for the players, and they've worked their whole life to make it happen, and especially for Sid and Malkin. And these kids are unbelievable, so very happy for them.
Sidney Crosby is your tenant. Will he be your tenant next year? And what do you tell him at the dinner table?
No, we, you know, I told him that he can stay as long as he wants. He's 21 years old. What is he going to do by himself? You know, he can buy a big house. He can do all that stuff. But I think the most important part for him is to have a family atmosphere, which he has with our kids. And that's all that matters. So he can stay as long as he wants.
Thanks a lot, Mero. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Way to go.
Okay, thanks.
Max Talbot with a couple, including the winner.
His 7th and 8th goal in a Stanley Cup Final, Game 7. Let's go to ice level here with Maxime Talbot.
Max, 2 goals.